Arithmetic Review, Fractions, Part 5. In this final video on fractions, we're going to go over how to compare fractions and work with fractions whose numerators or denominators are not necessarily integers. On occasions, the test might present you with math problems in which you're asked to compare two fractions and decide which fraction is larger. Say we are asked to compare the following two fractions, 3 sevenths and 7 twelfths. In order to make a comparison of two or more fractions, we need to rewrite both fractions so that they have a common denominator, similar to the way we added and subtracted fractions. So we essentially need to find a common multiple of 7 and 12. The quickest way to find a common multiple is by multiplying the denominators together. In this case, 7 times 12, which is equal to 84. So we multiply the numerator and denominator of the first fraction by 12, and multiply the numerator and denominator of the second fraction by 7. Doing that gives us the following equivalent fractions: 36 over 84 and 49 over 84. Now that both fractions have the same denominator, we can go ahead and compare the numerators to determine which fraction is bigger or which fraction is smaller. In this case, the second fraction is larger when compared to the first fraction. We can also compare more than two fractions. Say we are asked to compare the following three fractions: 3 sevenths, 4 eighths, and 7 over 11. One way in which we can compare all three fractions is to find the least common multiple between the denominators of all three fractions. You can always multiply all three denominators to find the common denominator. Then write an equivalent fraction by multiplying each fraction by an integer that would yield the common multiple as follows. At times, this method will be very time-consuming, since you might need to multiply each fraction by more than one number to obtain the common denominator. A better and slightly faster way of comparing fractions is by comparing two fractions at a time. Say we wanted to know which of these three fractions is the largest. We can start by comparing the first two fractions. Before we compare them, we first need to rewrite them so that both fractions have a common denominator. The easiest way to do this is by multiplying the denominator of one fraction with the numerator of the other fraction. In this case, we find the product of 7 and 4, which is equal to 28. This becomes the new numerator of the second fraction. In the same manner, we find the product of 8 and 3, which is equal to 24. This number becomes the numerator of the first fraction. Since all we need to compare is the numerator of the equivalent fractions, we can determine by observation that the second fraction is larger than the first, since 28 is greater than 24. So we can now cross out or eliminate the first fraction, since we concluded that it was smaller than the second fraction. Now we go ahead and compare the second fraction with the third fraction. Same deal, we multiply the denominator of one fraction with the numerator of the second fraction. This number becomes the new numerator that can be used to make a comparison. Carrying out the products, we see that the third fraction is larger than the second fraction, since 56 is greater than 44. So we conclude that the third fraction is the largest of the three. When using this method, always multiply from bottom to top, in the direction of the arrows. Working in the other direction or assigning the new numerator to the wrong fraction will give you the wrong answer. The last thing to keep in mind is to make sure you read the question correctly and determine the type of comparison they're asking you to make. They might ask which fraction is larger or which fraction is smaller. The next idea you need to be familiar with is that numbers of the form A over B may contain numbers in either A or B that are not necessarily integers. When you're face to face with these types of fractions, don't panic. These types of fractions can be manipulated just like fractions. For example, the numbers pi over 2 and pi over 3 can be added together as follows. The common denominator will be 6, so we go ahead and modify each fraction so that we obtain the common denominator 6. This means that we multiply the numerator and denominator of the first fraction by 3, and multiply the numerator and denominator of the second fraction by 2. Then it's just a matter of adding the numerators, in this case 3 pi plus 2 pi, which signifies to 5 pi. In the same manner, we can multiply these two numbers together, pi over 2 times pi over 3. Multiplying across gives us the final answer equal to pi squared over 6. Lastly, we can also divide these types of numbers together, like in the following complex fraction, pi over 2 divided by pi over 3. Recall that this is another way of denoting division, so we can rewrite the complex fraction horizontally as follows. Next, we go ahead and find the reciprocal of the second fraction, and change the division operator to a multiplication operator. Then, it's just a matter of multiplying across. Notice that the pi's cancel out, leaving behind the final answer equal to 3/2. The final types of problems you need to be careful with are problems that require you to perform a combination of the operations that were described in the previous videos. The important thing to remember is that the goal of all these steps and operations is to simplify the fractions. Let's go over the final example and simplify the following expression. The quantity 3/4 plus 1 over 7 times negative 2/5. Alright, we first want to add the fractions 3/4 and 1/7. So we go ahead and rewrite both fractions so that they have a common denominator. Then we add the numerators, keeping the common denominator. Doing that, we obtain the following fraction. Now we need to multiply these two fractions. Before we do that, notice that we can reduce the numerator 25 with the denominator 5. In addition, we can also reduce the denominator 28 with the numerator 2, yielding the following expression. Having reduced the fraction, we go ahead and multiply across, which results in the final answer equal to negative 5 over 14. Alright, and there you have it. These are the basic ideas that you need to keep in mind when dealing with fractions in the GRE. In the next series of videos, we're going to review decimals.